Hello viewer, my name is Ibnu Dul, a Form 3 student in Cornerbrook School. Welcome to Science Hub. I'll be taking you through binomial expansion. A binomial is an expansion of two terms. The two terms can be A and B, or X plus Y. These are the two terms. And so in book 2, we learn about the quadratic expansion, where we found A plus B, an exponent power 0, it becomes 1. And again, A plus B, an exponent power 1, it becomes A plus B. Again, we found that A plus B, exponent power 2, it becomes A squared plus AB, 2AB plus B squared. And we found that the coefficient of this A squared plus 2AB plus B squared, the coefficient of A squared is 1, of AB is 2, and of B squared is 1. So, because doing this to power more than 2, you find that it's tiresome. This is why the Pascal came up with the Pascal triangle. And the Pascal triangle is based on these expansions. Just for example, let me write A plus B power 3. You found that in Pascal triangle, it is 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 1, 3, 3, 1. So, to expand A plus B power 3, we use this Pascal triangle. We find what A, 1A. So when you start with A, using the Pascal triangle, the A will, when you are continuing, the A is going to reduce, the power of A is going to reduce, and the power of B is going to increase. So you start with A.
Excuse me. That thing is very trying to.
A raised to power 3 and B raised to power 0 remains 1, so there's no use of writing B power 0 plus 3 times B raised to power 1. Then you get 3 raised to power 3 times A raised to power 1 times B raised to power 2 plus 1 times A raised to power 0 times B raised to power 3. So, as I told you before, when you are continuing to expand this, these two numbers using binomial expansion, the power of A, the first number, is going to be decreasing, and the power of the second number is increasing. And so you finally come up with A, and 1 is usually there. So A power 3 plus 3 A squared B plus 3 AB squared plus B power 3. And again, you can do several examples like x plus y power 4. And we find in the pastoral triangle, this 1, 4, 6, 4, 1. So by using this one to solve the two expressions, we find that 1 times x power 4 plus 4 times x power 3 times y power 1 plus 6 times x power 2 times y power 2 plus 4 times x power 3 times y times power 1 times y power 3 plus 1 times x power 0 times y power 4. Then finally we have, you get x power 4 plus 4 x power 3 y plus 6 x squared y squared plus 4 x y power 3 plus y power 4. So the concept is the same. The first letter is going, is decreasing, and the second letter, the power of the second letter is increasing. And you can see how the binomial expansion is applied in numerical cases. So in numerical cases, like when you are given a number is numerical. So like one is that is numerical. So when you are given a number, like let me first write application. To numerical. Yes. For example, you are given a number like 1.02. You are told to use binomial expansion to evaluate this number to the power of 4. We are going to do this because in binomial expansion we are dealing with two numbers. So you are going to divide this to become two numbers. The first number will be 1, the second number will be plus 0.02, so that it becomes two number. It's power 4. And so you do it like we are doing with the letters. So it's power 4, we are going in the Pascal triangle. There's 1, 4, 6, 4, 1. Use these numbers to evaluate the two numbers you have in the board. Like the first one is 1. 1, you write it the power of 4. 1 times 1 power 4 times 0.02. Power 0 plus 1 plus 4 times 1 power 3 times 0.02 is 1 plus six times one times one is power two times 0.02 power two plus 4 times 1 is power 1 0.02 power 3 plus 1 times 0.02 is power 4. So as you've seen, and continuing, the first letter become, the power of the first letter decreases and the power of the second letter increases. So this one comes to be 1 raised power 4 is 1 times 0.0 raised power 1 power 0 become 1, and it also is just plus 0.08 plus 0.00 plus 0.0000 0.16. So you got them all, and you get that comes to be 1.0824. We live in 5 significant figures. And again, when you take a number like 1 was an addition. When you take a number like 0.98, you get that for you to come up with the two numbers, you write 1 plus 1 minus 1 minus 0.02. You are given this to raise power 4. 1 minus 0.02 raise power 4. Then you again write the binom, the Pascal triangle. Pascal triangle is 1 plus 1, 4, 6, 4, 1.
Excuse me. It pains. Please try to press it.
So that one is the number from the Pascal triangle, the digits from the Pascal triangle. So we use the digits from Pascal triangle to solve out this sum. So you write it 1 times 1 times 1 squared times 1 power 4 times 0.02. So it's negative 0.02 is equal to 0 plus 1 raised to power times 4 times 1 raised to power 3 times negative 0.02 power 1 plus 6 times 1 raised power 2 times negative 0.02 squared plus 4 times 1 raised power 1 times negative 0.02 raised power 3 times 1 times 1 raised power 0 times negative 0.02 raised power 4. So again, when you work this one's out, you get 0.1 plus 4 plus
please raise the chain.
Yes?
Press that command then.
Minus 0.2. You get 1. Get 1 minus 0.1 plus 4 times 1 power 3 times negative 0.01 is power 1. Okay. You get 0.1. Then this one here, 6 times 1 squared plus 0 minus 0.02 squared. So if you get this one here like this, the if you square it, the negative comes out and it becomes positive. So you plus 0.04, 0.004, plus, oh no, minus, 0.00005, plus 0.00008. So the final answer is just like you get as 0.904. This one is in 3 significant figures, in 4 significant figures. I've come to the end of discussion on Science Hub. My name is Kevin Odiwuoru. Keep it to Lim TV. Watch and learn.